How good would it be if you were told the very best bits from some of the world's best books without having to read a word? Well, that's exactly what our next guests have delivered in their podcast. Over the past 3 years, these two blokes from Melbourne have each read close to 400 non-fiction books. And each week they share the biggest lessons with their 180,000 plus listeners.
Now they've put the best excerpts into their very own book. Adam Ashton, Ashto, and Adam Jones. Jonesy joins us now from Melbourne. G'day, lads.
G'day. There's some shocking haircuts in. I don't know where you found that footage.
Oh, hey, great to see you fellas. I love this because I'm a big fan of self-help books, and there are so many on the market. You don't know where to start. A lot of it is kind of, it's hard to read through. You do the hard work. You do the heavy lifting. Read the books. Deliver the message. I love it. What was the book that set you on this path, Ashto?
For me, I was, I'd never read a book. Like, I'd read, you know, Shakespeare and Dickens during high school, but that sort of turned me off reading. It wasn't until I started entering the workforce, I read How to Win Friends and Influence People by Dale Carnegie, and just like my eyes were just open to a completely different way of just building relationships and talking to people, as the title suggests, winning friends and influencing people. And that sort of kicked off this reading journey. I thought, if one book can give me this much insight, what other books are out there? And we just haven't stopped reading since.
And Jonesy, the book that you read that changed your life probably saved your life as well.
That's right. Before reading, I was a pack-a-day smoker, bit of a party animal on the weekends, drank a lot, and my whole motto in life was just let future Adam worry about it. But eventually future Adam was going to come back. But luckily someone told me about the book, Alan Carr's Easy Way to Stop Smoking. And this book not only made me quit smoking, but it made me actually enjoy the whole process. And I thought, right, the average smoker spends about $1 million in their lifetime on ciggies. And, you know, this book only cost me $50. So for a return on investment for $1 million for $50, I was absolutely hooked on books. And this is where the reading journey really, really began. And by the end of it, culminated in this book. So we've got 115 books, all covered in one, with similar ROI to that very first book, which was Alan Carr's Easy Way to Stop Smoking.
It is awesome. Boys, I jumped straight on board when I heard, Jones, you had a section in this book about non-wanker philosophy. Oh. Pray tell.
Oh, Tristan, mate, like, when we think about philosophy, I think we think about people in caves with just old beards and just sitting there pondering about concepts that just got no practical value for us in our lives. But in doing the podcast and reading so many books on philosophy, there are so many great ideas that actually have a lot of practical value. So I'll give you one idea, and this is hedonic adaptation. So it's the idea about when you buy something, you got this initial buzz and you feel good about having this new purchase, but eventually you might have a few pay rises and you think, oh, I don't like that old car anymore. You know, I need to upgrade to something new. And this can go on and on and on. It doesn't matter how much money you earn. You could be a McDonald's fry cook or an NBA basketballer earning the big bucks. You could be on this treadmill and you can end up broke. So, you know, being conscious of hedonic adaptation, which is an old Stoic philosophy idea, number one, we don't have to try and keep up with the Joneses all the time and just can be satisfied with what we got. And number two, we can just enjoy our lives without feeling that need that we need to go out there and buy more things.
Yeah, it sounds like that book, Affluenza. Have you heard of it? Another non-fiction book about, yeah, our materialism in the Western world. You've interviewed your favourite authors and all-time heroes, a couple of prime ministers in there as well, Malcolm Turnbull and Kevin Rudd. Ashto, what surprising life lessons do these former PMs share?
I guess the most surprising for us, we were just, you know, two blokes who met at a pub and we thought, oh my goodness, like these prime ministers, they must be the most, you know, the top of the top of humanity. And of course they are, but at the same time, they're just sort of normal blokes like you and I guess, like Jonesy and I.
Yeah, 100%. They actually started playing, Kevin Rudd started playing the piano at after one of our podcasts, and, you know, we really connected in that. And I think, like, a lot of us go below the belt when it comes to our politicians, but they're just normal people, and we need to just treat them like normal human beings. They've been a tough time. I mean, politics, it can be such a dirty game up in Canberra. You know, and that's another one of our chapters in our book is The People and Power, where we draw from Niccolo Machiavelli in a book called The Prince. It's about 500 years old. And it's just a way of stepping out of being naive and just realising, you know, some people out there are out to manipulate and hurt in their careers, whether it be politics or your own career, whatever industry it might be. But for these guys, they got chewed up and spat out by some of the most manipulative people in Canberra, I think.
Yeah, you have to admit, though, that Malcolm Turnbull book, I tried to read that. That's a chore. No way.
It's a big book. It was about the size of this one, 680 pages.
I love the fact that you two, you break down books that have completely changed your life. You even have a podcast. I went to sleep listening to you guys
last night. We put you to sleep, that's good.
No, I didn't mean it like that, but you lulled me to sleep. What I wonder, though, is the whole point of a motivational book is to change your life, right? So isn't it cheating a little bit by not actually reading the book and just getting you guys to tell us the best bits?
I think there's two parts of reading a book. One is reading a book and getting the information, getting the knowledge. But as you say, the second part is actually doing something about it. So what we're trying to do is we read the books, we try to do something. We're giving the listeners or the readers the best bits so that they can, I guess, shorten the cycle that it takes to get the knowledge, and they can spend more time on actually putting it into action.
And that's a really good point, Sarah, because, you know, after listening to our podcast where we do short summaries, I think people read more rather than less. They don't just listen to us and think, all right, that's it, I got it. They think, all right, that book sounds awesome, I'm going to go and buy the full thing and read it. And that's similar with our book. I mean, 115, we'll just give a small taste of it. And after it, we expect your reading list to just grow exponentially because, you know, we get so much out of books. And if something resonates, I think anyone should go out there, buy the full book from the author themselves.
All right. Well, I think that's the best part about your book as well.
Yeah, you can order the stuff they never taught you at whatyouwilllearn.com. Astro and Jonesy, such a pleasure. Thanks for joining us, guys.
Thank you so much. It was great to chat.
Keep up the great work, guys.
Is a very good podcast. Didn't put me to sleep, by the way. Now, a new push to legalise marijuana. That story is up next.
Yeah, and then who wouldn't want to work in paradise? And Queensland has added extra sweeteners to woo workers there. Find out all about it after this. Can't touch.